क्लास ट्वेल्थ सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स 13th चैप्टर एसी सर्किट्स फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी शार्पनेस ऑफ रेजोनेंस दैट इज क्यू फैक्टर शार्पनेस ऑफ रेजोनेंस दैट इज क्यू फैक्टर वी नो दैट द एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ करंट इन सीरीज एलसीआर सर्किट इज गिवन एज द एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ मैक्सिमम करंट इन सीरीज रेजोनेंस सर्किट आई जीरो इक्वल टू ई जीरो बाय झेड वेर ई जीरो इज पीक वैल्यू ऑफ ईएमएफ एंड झेड इज द इम्पेडेंस ऑफ दिस सर्किट इट विल बी ऑल्सो रिटर्न एज ई जीरो अपॉन स्क्वेर रूट ऑफ आर स्क्वेर प्लस ओमेगा एल माइनस वन अपॉन ओमेगा सी होल स्क्वेर इफ ओमेगा इज वैरिड इफ ओमेगा इज चेंज और वैरिड देन एट ए पर्टिकुलर फ्रिक्वेंसी ओमेगा इक्वल टू ओमेगा आर दैट इज एंगुलर फ्रिक्वेंसी ओमेगा इक्वल टू एंगुलर फ्रिक्वेंसी एट रेजोनेंस एक्सएल इक्वल टू एक्ससी दैट इज इंडक्टिव रिएक्टन्स इज इक्वल टू कपैसिटिव रिएक्टन्स एंड हेन्स वी कैन राइट ओमेगा आर एल इक्वल टू वन अपॉन ओमेगा आर सी बिकॉज एक्सएल इक्वल टू ओमेगा आर एल एंड एक्ससी इक्वल टू वन अपॉन ओमेगा आर सी फॉर ए गिवन वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस आर फॉर ए गिवन वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस आर द एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ करंट इज मैक्सिमम फॉर ए गिवन वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस आर द एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ करंट इज मैक्सिमम व्हेन ओमेगा आर एल माइनस वन अपॉन ओमेगा आर सी इक्वल टू जीरो सो व्हेन दिस डिफरेंस इज इक्वल टू जीरो द एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ करंट इज मैक्सिमम एंड देयरफॉर वी कैन राइट ओमेगा आर स्क्वेर इक्वल टू वन अपॉन एल सी और ओमेगा आर इक्वल टू वन अपॉन रूट एल सी सो दिस इक्वेशन विल गिव अस द एंगुलर फ्रिक्वेंसी ओमेगा आर दैट इज फ्रिक्वेंसी एट द रेजोनेंस of that circuit and therefore the value of omega other than omega r if the value of omega is omega r then for values of omega other than omega r the amplitude of current is always less than the maximum value I zero so at omega r only the current will be maximum and for all other values other than omega r that current will be less than its maximum value or peak value I zero if the value of omega is chosen such that amplitude of the current is 1 by root 2 times the maximum value that is when I is equal to 1 by root 2 times I zero at that time the power dissipated by the circuit becomes half so when current I is equal to I zero by root 2 at that time the power dissipated is half of its maximum value and therefore if we now plot the graph of amplitude of current I versus angular frequency omega then the nature of the graph is as shown for different values of resistance R So the first curve will represent this resonance curve will represent for high value of resistance R. So for high value of resistance R, the peak of this resonance curve will be slightly flat. Then second curve will represent for moderate value of resistance R and this third curve will represent for low value of resistance R. So for low value of resistance R, the sharpness of this resonance curve will be maximum. So as value of resistance in that series LCR circuit decreases, the sharpness of the resonance curve increases. And therefore, if you consider the region on the left side of this angular frequency omega r so this portion of this resonance curve then this portion or this region will be dominated in capacitive reactance xc that is xc will be greater than xl that is for this portion on the left side of omega r the capacitive reactance will be greater than the inductive reactants. On the other hand, towards right side of this omega R, this region will be dominated in inductive reactants XL, that is XL will be greater than XC. So here on left side of omega R, this resonance curve will be capacitive. On right side, it will be inductive. Now, if you consider these two frequencies omega 1 and omega 2, then difference between these two frequencies omega 2 minus omega 1, that will be equal to twice of delta omega, which is called as bandwidth, and therefore bandwidth will be equal to 2 delta omega. So this difference between omega 1 and omega r is delta omega. Similarly, difference between this will be again delta omega, and therefore we can write from this figure omega 1, this omega 1 will be equal to omega r minus this omega r minus this delta omega. Similarly, omega 2 will be equal to omega r plus this delta omega. So omega 1 equal to omega r minus delta omega, and omega 2 equal to omega r plus delta omega. Now, from this graph, as we have seen that omega 1 is equal to omega r minus delta omega, and omega 2 is equal to omega r plus delta omega, we can say that there are two values of omega, as omega 1 and omega 2, one greater and other smaller. That is, in this case, omega 2 is greater than omega 1 and symmetrical about omega r. So omega 1 and omega 2 will be symmetric about this omega r, that is angular frequency omega r. Now the difference between omega 1 and omega 2 will be nothing but the bandwidth. So this is the bandwidth, that is denoted by twice delta omega. Similarly, from this graph, again it is clear that for lower angular frequency state, the resonance curve is dominated by capacitive reactants, and higher angular frequency side is dominated by inductive reactants. That is, for lower frequency, it is dominated by the capacitive reactants, and for higher frequencies, it is dominated by the inductive reactants. And now, let us see what is Q factor or quality factor. So for that, this quantity, the quantity omega r upon 2 delta omega, is the measure of the sharpness of the resonance. The sharpness of the resonance will be determined by using this relation omega r upon 2 delta omega. And therefore, the sharpness of the resonance will be given in terms of quality factor at or Q factor, where Q factor will be defined as the Q factor of series resonance circuit is defined as the ratio of resonant frequency to the difference in frequencies taken on both sides of the resonant frequency, such that each frequency the current amplitude becomes 1 by root 2 times the value of resonant frequency. So the Q factor of the series resonance circuit is defined as the ratio of resonant frequency, the ratio of resonant frequency, that is omega r, to the difference between the two frequencies taken on both sides, that is omega 1 and omega 2 of that resonant frequency, such that the frequency for this each frequency, the current amplitude becomes, the current amplitude is E0 by 2R, that is, it is nothing but 1 by root 2 times of its maximum value. And therefore, the quality factor Q will be given as angular frequency omega R divided by difference between two frequencies, that is omega 2 minus omega 1, and that will be written as omega r upon 2 delta omega. But this omega r will represent resonant frequency and 2 delta omega will represent bandwidth. Therefore, q is equal to resonant frequency upon bandwidth. So the q factor is dimensionless. This q factor is dimensionless. And now let us see the next point, that is choke coil. What is that choke coil? The resistance reduces current passing through the AC circuit. So the resistance of the AC circuit will reduce the current passing through it, but there is loss of electric energy in the form of heat energy. There will be loss of electric energy in the form of heat energy, and hence a choke coil helps to minimize this heat loss. The choke will try to minimize this heat loss, and therefore a choke coil is an inductor. The choke coil is an inductor, so that is the coil used to reduce the current passing through the circuit without large amount of loss of heat. So with minimum loss of heat energy, the current will be passed through the circuit by using the choke coil. It consists of thick laminated copper wire wound closely in a large number of turns over the soft iron laminated core. So choke coil consists of the thick laminated copper wire wound closely in a large number of turns over the soft iron laminated core. Then it offers large resistance XL. It offers large resistance XL equal to omega L to the AC, and current is reduced. Now in this case, the laminated core reduces AD current loss. AD current loss will be reduced with the help of laminated core. The average power dissipated. Now the average power dissipated in the choke coil is, the average power dissipated in the choke coil is given by the formula P equal to IRMS into ERMS into cos phi. Power dissipated P equal to IRMS into ERMS into cos phi, where power factor cos phi will be given as R upon square root of R square plus omega square L square. Cos phi equal to R upon square root of R square plus omega square L square. And then for a choke coil, the inductance L is very large. Hence, R is very small and cos phi is nearly zero, and the power loss is very small. The only loss of energy is due to the hysteresis loss, that is due to magnetization and demagnetization of that iron core. Hysteresis loss will take place, and therefore the only loss of energy is due to the hysteresis loss in the iron core, which can be reduced by using a soft iron core. So by using soft iron core, the hysteresis loss will be reduced.